हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर मिस अदिति अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मसी इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टेक्निक्स फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मसी चांदोरी नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक पाउडर्स, दैट इज ग्रैन्यूल्स फ्रॉम फार्मास्यूटिक्स टू पाउडर्स ग्रैन्यूल्स। द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर एज फॉलोज: डेफिनेशन ऑफ पाउडर, इंट्रोडक्शन टू ग्रैन्यूल्स, advantages of granules, granulation methods, wet granulation, dry granulation, fluid bed granulation and effervescent granules. Powders: a pharmaceutical powder is a mixture of finely divided drugs or chemicals in a dry form meant for internal or external use. A powder is a dry bulk solid composed of a large number of very fine particles that may flow freely when shaken or tilted. Granules: the granules are the agglomerates of powdered materials prepared into larger free-flowing particles. They typically fall within the range of 850 micrometer to, that is number 20 sieve, to 4.75 millimeter number 4 sieve size. The shape of granules is generally irregular. Advantages of granules: granules are usually made as a step to prepare tablets. Granules flow into the dyes more evenly and more freely than particles from the hopper, the funnel-like container holding the drug to guide its flow into the tableting press. A few advantages of granules over the powders are: first one, granules flow better than powders. The easy flow characteristics are important in supplying the drug materials from the hopper or feeding container into the tableting process. For this reason, the powder mixtures are usually granulated if they are intended to be compressed into the tablets. The granules also eliminate or control the dust. Second advantage, granules increase compressibility. Third advantage, granules have the smaller surface area than a comparable volume of powders. This makes granules more stable physically and chemically than the corresponding powders. Granules are less likely to cake or harden upon standing than the powders. Granules are more easily wetted by a solvent than are certain powders, so that the granules are also preferred in making solutions. For an example, principine, that is ampicillin, for oral suspension. Ampicillin is unsuitable in aqueous solution, so it is usually prepared as a granules and reconstituted by a pharmacist with the purified water just prior to dispensing. The granules also contain colorants, flavorants and other pharmaceutical ingredients, so the resulting solution or suspension has all the desired medicinal and pharmaceutical features of a liquid pharmaceutical. Fifth advantage is, granules produce particle size uniformity, thus the content uniformity. Granulation methods: in that first method, that is a wet granulation. In a wet granulation, a liquid binder or an adhesive is first added to the powder mixture. The wetted mass is then passed through a screen of the desired mesh size and resulting granules are dried. The dried granules, it can be passed through a second screen of a smaller mesh to reduce the size of the granules even further. Overwetting usually results in a granules that are too hard for proper tableting, while underwetting usually results in the preparation of tablets that are too soft and tend to crumble. Binding agents commonly used in a wet granulation are a 10 to 20% aqueous solution of cornstarch, a 25 to 50% of glucose solution, molasses, various polysaccharide, for an example, acacia gum, Cellulose derivatives such as methyl cellulose, carboxymethyl cellulose, and microcrystalline cellulose, gelatins, and povidone, that is polyvinyl pyrrolidone, that is called PVP. Wet granulation, the processing steps are raw materials, then weighing, screening, wet massing, sieving or milling, simply size reduction, then drying, screening, mixing and compression. Second method of granulation, that is a dry granulation. In dry granulation, granules are formed by compacting large masses of the powder mixture and subsequently the crushing into the pieces. These pieces are then sized into smaller granules. The dry granulation method requires the drug or the diluent to have cohesive properties for the large masses to be formed. The powder is slugged or compressed into large flat tablets or pellets of about 1 inch, that is 3 by 4 inch or larger in a diameter. In slugging, lubricants are required for release tablets from dye. The slugs are then broken up and passed through a desired mesh for sizing. Dry granulation processing steps are raw material, then weighing, screening, mixing, slugging, milling, again screening, mixing and compression. In roller compaction, the powder is fed into two rollers. In both are either flat or complementarily patterned to form a ribbon of compacted powder. The ribbon is subsequently milled and sieved to produce a powder with the better flow properties. These methods are chosen when a drug and other materials cannot be processed by wet granulation method owing to their degradation by moisture or by elevated temperature for drying. Thus, it is ideal for processing moisture and heat sensitive materials. Aspirin is commonly prepared into tablets after slugging since it is hydrolyzed on exposure to moisture. Then third one, that is fluid bed granulation. Since microparticles are considered as a granules, approaches of making the microparticles such as fluid bed drying technology, it can be used for granulation. A granulating solution is spread onto the suspended particles that are then dried rapidly in the suspending air. The next, effervescent granules. This type of medicament granules are prepared for internal use. In that, medicaments mixed with citric acid, tartaric acid and sodium bicarbonate with the sweetening agents also present. When contact with water, the release of carbon dioxide to mask the bitter and saline taste of the drug. Also, carbon dioxide stimulates the flow of gastric juice and helps in absorption of medicaments. The methods of preparation of effervescent granules are first one heat method, second wet method. Heat method, firstly porcelain dish make hot on water bath before transferring the powder. Then transfer the medicament with the citric acid and the other ingredients. In that stage, the citric acid, it liberates the water and produces the dump mass. Heating stage takes 1 to 5 minutes. Then damp mass pass through sieve and dry in a hot air oven at 60 degrees Celsius, then finally packed in airtight container. Second, that is a wet method for producing effervescent granules. That is, in this method, the ingredients are mixed with the alcohol to produce coherent mass. Produced mass pass through sieve number 10 or 8 and dry in hot air oven at 60 degrees Celsius. Then dried granules are again passed through the sieve to break the lumps which may be formed during drying. Finally, the prepared granules are packed in airtight containers. What we learned from these powders, that is granules, the learning outcomes are: what is powders, then what is granules, advantages of granules, how to prepare the granules, means granulation methods, In that, first one wet granulation, second one dry granulation, third one fluid bed granulation, and effervescent granules. Thank you.